Right, good afternoon everybody and welcome to the 2012 season of Rugby Union with the Lane Cove Junior Rugby Club.
We should all join in the chorus, and maybe the grown-ups, it's not a hard chorus to grab, you might like to join in too.
Even if you don't believe us,
it's a story of all
that song was written by one of our team members in 1954, and after every game, we sang that song with gusto and pride.
Well, the Lane Cove in the 50s was very much a working class suburb.
Had a brickworks, and all the blokes like were carpenters or fitters and turners or, you know, tradesmen of some sort.
You held your breath when you went in the Lane Cove pub for a drink, I can tell you that. You had to look sideways, backwards, and everyone. You had to be very careful down there.
Well, they had the big brickwork, didn't they, years ago then. Well, it was a long way out of town. The champs used to come down there. Minutes from the Lane Cove Football Club. I put them somewhere and I don't know. I can't find them now. No.
Jack Carroll was convinced that there was something to be had from sub-district rugby, and he went around starting clubs, getting people to start clubs, finding presidents for them, he and Benny Pittaway started, as far as I'm concerned, Lane Cove Club.
Dick Notley. I mean, if Dick Notley hadn't been involved, there would not be a Lane Cove Rugby Club today. He got the blokes. We haven't got a team, so Dick would do his rounds at the pub. He'd start up at the Longville pub, he'd go to the Great Northern. He couldn't find someone there, he'd go down to Willoughby.
I can still remember the first meeting. We had it in the School of Arts at Lane Cove upstairs.
Upstairs.
And Darvill Hunt.
Darvill Hunt.
Nick was Australian Rugby Union. He was very helpful.
I mean, Johnny was in touch with Len Pittaway, because he was one of the original. Yeah. He was the driving force.
He and Len, and we had all these blokes from around Lane Cove, Ryan Ganane and Rex Cutters and Bobby Hall and Johnny Wall and all these guys who'd played with us for a few years. You know, we only ever had about 12 players, and so we used to go up to the pub and get whooping with Garrity and those blokes.
We were recruiting kids for any age we could get, and once we got enough kids of an age, we started a team. And we started eventually came up with under eights onwards.
My father was a merchant seaman, so I didn't see a lot of him. And when I went to Lane Cove, those men who coaches and also men who were managers had a very positive influence on me. They were good men. They were good men. John Leckie and Gordon Bleakhorn, Jim Knox, Bill Twyble and his car trials, Ken Oliver and Gordon Blinkhorn's golf days, Dave Kenton-Smith, Jackie Somerville, Noel Walness, and they had all played for Lane Cove and then came back to Lane Cove. We were so fortunate to have these really good men, not role models, but they really just gave you an enthusiasm for what you're doing, you know, camaraderie, mateship, and they were really good blokes.
Alan Osborne. Now there was a fellow, never played, but you wouldn't have wanted a loyaler club member. He worked hard. And he was made a life member.
The only reason I actually became secretary is they invited me along to the annual meeting and somebody nominated me and I didn't know what the word decline meant. So that's how I became the secretary of Lane Cove Rugby Union.
I've got a theory that the culture of Lane Cove Rugby, for my generation, really started in the bull ring at the Lane Cove Primary School, because it was this concrete area, and three mornings out of five, I reckon, we were down there at before school playing British Bulldog. And there was take no prisoners. It was tagging, tackling, eliminations, it was on. And then on the weekend, of course, we played with Lane Cove. And yeah, Jack Houghton was our coach, a really good coach, I remember. Again, it was this bunch of guys from the local neighbourhood, the Ian Calthorpes, the Michael Keane, the Robbie Ford. We'd, after school, head off to St. Ignatius across the road, Riverview, and watch the first 15 train. And I think one day the All Blacks were there, and we'd kick the ball, play footy, and dream about playing for Gordon and stuff like that. Well, that's what Lane Cove was. We were a neighbourhood playing together. Every family, like in Riverview, we all got together. We'd come up here and play for Lane Cove in the under-10s, I think we started up. And Dad, my father Des, was manager of our team. And then Mum, of course, would wash. She'd be washing 15 white jerseys during the week.
Ready for the ferry for nowhere?
You can see Hunters Hill High, which was the source of a lot of players for Lane Cove, St Joseph's College and Riverview College.
Quite a few schools that came together on the training paddock.
The important thing about training was getting to the Longable Hotel before it closed.
Yeah, strict schedule.
Lining up your schooners at the end to belt them down between 10 o'clock.
I mean, we did juniors, we played at Tantallon Oval, which, you know, was called Concussion Oval, that bull-eye soil in the middle. And when you train on it, if it was wet, and it'd sort of dry out to be like jagged glass.
In 1965, the club came from a one-team sub-district club to four teams, and that was with the help of a lot of young fellas who were coming up through the grades through the 16s and 18s and were very successful. With the great assistance of Bruce Corlett, who seemed to be able to know all sorts of people, we accumulated a pretty good nucleus of about 60 to 70 players, and the following two or three years, we won everything that sub-district football could ever provide. I think probably our most successful year was in 1968 when we not only won those but won the club championship.
They were, after their 60, at their 66, if that was the year, the best team in the competition.
Having instilled in them the will to win and the commitment and some good tactics and some fitness, I think we probably could say that of all the clubs in the history of sub-district, we transformed the culture of the whole competition, and the results speak for themselves.
I just want to let you know that we've got 350 junior players registered this year to play for Lane Cove Rugby Club.
10 minutes,
I say it every week, it's crucial. Big John back up.
Well, for the founders of the club, if it wasn't for you fellas, we wouldn't be here playing Cantown today. That's what it's all about, the spirit of this ground. You can feel it in the grandstand, you can feel it down in the change room. It's definitely there, there's something there, and that's why we all play, because we love the spirit of this club.
These boys were state champions, but they turned out next Saturday morning to coach the under-10s and under-12s.
that was the spirit of Lane Cove.